The wait-and-see approach for me enters the equation, Jonathan, when everybody's talking about this dude like he's the second coming. Just stop it. It's one game. One game. And you of all people, I would advise you strongly to watch your mouth, watch your tone, watch your inflections, watch the way you stare at me, to hold it, because you was similar to this with Baker Mayfield last year. I will remind you of that. I didn't say you off Baker, but you damn sure ain't on him either. Let's be clear about that. Let's be clear.
He also doesn't play football for the New York Giants.
All I'm trying to say is let's be clear. Daniel Jones was nice. He had a game. He had a good game. All right? I like what I saw. I give him props. But to act like this dude is the second coming. Can I get more than one game, particularly against somebody other than Tampa? That's all I'm asking. This is a man's game. This is a man's game. Boys out there now. This is a man's game. You can't just because you look good one week, they got an extra week of film on you now. Let's be clear.
From time to time, I like to quote the late, great Biggie Smalls to you, player hater. Turn your head round.
Hater.
Lay on the ground.
You've been wrong. Yes.
Stephen A. Daniel Jones, my team, the New York Football
Giants.
Your team. That's right.
Keep going.
Who I've been suffering watching a non-starter start games for several years now. Eli was not one of the best 32 starters in football. Mm-hmm. He was a mid-level backup quarterback. He could not make throws. He didn't even read defenses anymore.
Right,
he was immobile. He was terrible, right?
Right.
My team reaches at number six and takes a quarterback, and I'm sitting here going, all right, you better be right. Don't be wrong on this one because that's a reach. They were right. How do I know? Okay. What do you look for in a quarterback? Wait, is the jury still out? Is it wait and see? The fumbling, yes. He has an issue with fumbling. I'm not going to, like, let that go away. I got to see him. I'm not talking about throwing interceptions. I mean ball security. Okay, let's just table that for a second. Time will tell. The prerequisite for a quarterback is, can you make all the throws? The answer is yes, he can make all the throws. Whatever you think about his arm strength, he can make every throw.
Right.
Like, Chad Pennington was excellent. Alex Smith was very good. But their arm strength was an issue. That is not Daniel Jones. Daniel Jones has an arm. That's not the most important thing, but it's a prerequisite. Most important thing, leadership. Do you feel like he's the kind of guy his teammates will follow? That's impossible to know at this point. But when I saw Dak Prescott in the preseason for the Cowboys a couple years ago, I said, he has it. That guy has it. When I see Daniel Jones, I see that it's not exactly like Dak Prescott, but the same sort of feeling. He's good. I'm not worried about that with him. He'll have to prove that wrong to me. Okay. Does he process? Now let's get to the stuff a quarterback actually does on the field. Does he process information quickly? That's the most important thing. Yes. Yes, he does. He's a rookie, and he's doing it very quickly. Arm talent, not just strength, but can he put the ball on a guy's steps to the back shoulder and double cover? He does all that stuff, and he's done it so far consistently in the preseason, first against the twos, then against the ones, then in a regular season game. And then finally, especially in the modern NFL, is he athletic? Yeah, he's not just athletic enough. He's athletic. He has every single thing you want to see in a quarterback prospect. So far, so good, and I will be damned if I let you rain on my parade as a Giants fan.
So everything you said is excitement about what he can be, not what he is, right?
No, I think he is. Those
it can't be because you haven't seen enough of him to say this is what he is, right? So you're saying this is what he can be, and this is what you're excited about. That's fine. But I know when I played rookie quarterbacks, we got after him. And we didn't stop getting after him until we said, okay, he knows what he's doing. We're going to back off. Cam Newton, his first year, as soon as we saw him, we said, we're going to light him up. We're going to light him up. Blitz, 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 until we can't blitz anymore. And then we'll figure out, can he be that guy? Daniel Jones hasn't faced that yet. Because as we sit here and talk about, okay, I understand all the metrics that you brought out. You didn't bring up accuracy, which is most important, but that's fine. All the other metrics that were brought up, defensive coordinators are going to sit there now, as Stephen A. mentioned, and said, all right, what does he really do well? Watching him now, all I see are crossing routes. He's just hitting crossing routes, and then you have a tight end as fast as a wide receiver going up the sideline. He wasn't great on the deep balls. He was good. He wasn't great on the deep balls. And by the way, he had a lot of time. So now, if you say, These crossing routes are going to take a little time. I can match that up easily. And I can blitz them. And I can disguise defenses. Now let me see, can Daniel Jones be a franchise quarterback? Because Eli did that for you. Eli did all that for you. All the top-tier quarterbacks have done that for you on a consistent basis.
If only Daniel Jones had ever worked with anyone who also worked with Eli and thought a lot of Daniel Jones as it relates to that.
You're telling me that that coach, he's only coached three quarterbacks, Eli, Peyton, and him?
No, but the fact
he's coached other quarterbacks that didn't perform.
The fact that the Giants reached for Daniel Jones
that's fine.
Is because they have very solid information by someone who knows him well and knows the guy you brought up as an example of someone who can do that well and said, this guy has the same thing.
It doesn't mean he's the guy. There are a lot of people that have the same qualities. We've seen top picks go come and go,
what
right?
What would your bet be?
My bet will be
that. Where are you putting your money?
My bet will be that after 8 games, we'll be coming back here talking about Daniel Jones again. And if he's performed, then we'll say he has a chance.
Is he the truth or not?
He has a chance.
Is he the truth
he's not
or
the
not?
Truth.
No he's way. Not the truth.
How can he be the truth?
We don't know that yet.
But I'm asking you to make an educated guess.
Wait, excuse me. I'm talking about
Wait.
You've just been down in the dumps for so long.
Not just that. That's the problem. That's true. But there's another thing. We don't want to hear about your guesses because you guess with 6 different angles. Don't tie that on us. The fact that
one angle.
Excuse me.
I'm saying is he the truth or not?
Did you just bring up the fumbles? Did you not say that? Let me ask you a question. If he fumbles the ball, right? And he's giving away the football on turnovers, right? How would you know what he's going to be?
That's a fixable problem.
It's a fixable. Really?
Okay. And if it doesn't get fixed by weekend, is he still the truth?
Hold on. That's something that could undo anyone. I'm betting it will.
I'll give you this. I won't rain on your parade. They played Tampa last week. This week they go against the 30th ranked defense in the Washington Redskins.
Oh, excuses. He's still
28 excuses.
You're already making excuses.
What I'm saying is, you're probably going to have another week.
Oh, I see. To not give him credit?
Right.
We're saying he's a good quarterback.
NFC Offensive Player of the Week.
When you're saying he's the truth, that's completely different than saying he's a good quarterback.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.